as you know, Linda Miller couldn't be here tonight. Her daughter Jamie had surgery this week, so keep her in your prayers. The Lord's going to keep a close and watchful eye over her family during this uncertain time as well. I've been going through some issues with my heart myself. The doctors say I live with AFib, arterial fibrillation, where the heart skips a beat, and I have a skip in my rhythm. Well, the rougher and tougher it gets these days, it seems the more the rhythms skip. So, I just know this is the way Satan would like to get his biggest stronghold in our lives, and just put a hold on the ministry altogether if he could. But tonight, through the blood of Jesus Christ, I want to rebuke Satan for any stronghold he has. And I would ask you as a church to take our request home to your families and add us to your prayer list on a daily basis as well, that we'll get through these uncertain days. You know, we're only promised a short time on this earth. The Bible says our lives appear as a vapor that appeareth for a short while, and it's gone. To some, that might seem like an eternity. To some, and all the evolution people would attest to this, this is all there is. Well, my Bible preaches differently. My Bible says there is a God in heaven. My Bible says that God has a Son. His name is Jesus. And he came, he bled, and he died to redeem the sins of all mankind. And we have a heaven, we have a home in heaven for sure, when we take upon Jesus as our Lord and Savior. That's what we've done. Teresa and I have picked one song that we have sung with Redemption over the years. And the testimony of this song talks to us about that. It was a request as well, wasn't it? That's right. Simply, he touched me. We often use the touch from the Lord down then. Amen. Thank you. King Jesus, well, I believe he's about God, our mansion's ready. The Lord said himself, he says, I'm going to go away and prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also. In my Father's house are many mansions, but were not so, I would have told you. Comfort one another with these words. Is that a comforting thought? It gets me through my day. But I can't do it alone. I can't do it without you guys. I can't do it without this church. It's because of the fellowship. It's because of the assembly of ourselves together here, whenever we do meet, that re-energizes me, that puts a spark back in my fire. It gives me the strength to go another week. I just want you to know that personally. I love each and every one of you because the Lord has given us a bond of fellowship. And I cling to that bond. I depend on you guys. Just to see your smiling face every time that you will come and fellowship and be a part of this church. I know we've got visitors here tonight. It's not from White Avenue. You might have your home church. But if you're at a crossroads and you don't quite have that fellowship, may I invite you personally to come here? This is one happy family. This is one happy family of God in this church. White Avenue Baptist Church. We meet here at 10:45 for AM service every Sunday. Sunday school kicks off at 9:30. So if you don't have a place to go, we'd love to have you here.
And we sing these songs every Sunday.
We sing these songs every week. We're going to sing it, but they kick us out. Glad to serve. We sure are. Okay, we've got a couple songs. We want to close this out because it's about time for dessert. Right? No, we didn't bring dessert. Okay, you have to get your own dessert. You didn't bring the ice cream again. Filled up with inspiration tonight. Are we not?
Amen.
We're fueled up with celebrate because it's only Saturday night. You've got all of tomorrow to sing these songs again, either here or at your own church. Let's see if I can get one more song out of this keyboard. I got to put in another quarter. Dennis still got juice back there, right?
I think so.
Good old Baptist message. We've got a good sermon. Okay.
Thank you all for coming out tonight.